G'day everyone and welcome back to NS2HD. This is game three in a matchup between Keed and Team 156. This is a casual weekend matchup. If you haven't seen games one and two, check them out. They are already up on the channel and you may watch them to your heart's content, but definitely watch them before you see this one because I'm going to start coming out with spoilers in about 10 seconds. For now, I am sitting in the ready room with the two teams. We've just had a server restart to ensure stability because sometimes that happens in the beta, but we're almost ready to go. I think we have on the Keyed side Smorg, Bearglue, me, Fish, Wildman, and Vez, and on the Team 156 side we have Shiv, Squidget, Persian Immortal, McGlaspie, Gunter, Scotty Bob, Rodog. Before this game starts, want to make a note that the tournament, the NS2HD Natural Selection 2 Beta Tournament, is hotting up. There are 14 teams registered, so there's only two team slots left. I believe one will be a public players team, and so there's really, I think, only one team left for a clan or otherwise organized group team. So definitely get in there and snap up that slot if you are at all interested, because time is running out to go for that prize pool. I'm ready. This is being live cast, so I am talking while they play. And 156 is lined up on their side. Keed is on their side, and they're saying go, go, go. And there they are. They are joining the teams. I'm going to jump into spectator mode. The 15-second warm-up period has started. And getting 156 Shiv. There we go. Here we are on the Marine side as both teams mess around in the 15 seconds they have before the game starts. So we've had one victory to Keed and 156. Keed and 156 both won as the alien team. And we're going to see now if 156 can end that trend and win as Marines in this game. So a victory in the first game from Keed with a rush on the infantry portals, and a victory to 156 in the second game by grinding down Keed with fades. Looks like there is a fight in data core. I went for flight control with my single perspective, so I am missing that. I'm very appreciative to all those people who have offered to dual perspective with me. I'm not doing it not because I don't have anyone to do it with me. It's because when I do these weekend games and there's lots of them happening and I want to bring them to you quickly, it's just 20 times faster, often literally, to bring it to you as a single perspective game. We already have a Skulk on the infantry portals. Bearglue on the infantry portal is going to take down Squidget. It's now going to be up to the commander, Scotty Bob, to take down this Skulk because there's no more Marines in here. This is seriously bad for the Marine team right now. 156 needs to lock this down as quickly as possible. There we go, Bearglue going down after doing 12% damage to that infantry portal, but more importantly, pulling the Marines back from their forward positions. Gonna allow Vez to do damage to 156's extractor in ventilation, and we have cloaked aliens moving in, so it looks like Keed has gone for a very fast shade, and they are gonna try and get some cloaked aliens in here. Now, this is not an exploit, as some people said it was when Keed did this a couple of games ago. If you are in range of a shade and the commander uses the cloaking ability, anything in that radius will be cloaked, and anything that is cloaked in that radius can then move. It is supposed to be, I believe, for 15 seconds. It may be lasting a little bit longer in 184. There might be a bug happening there, but not substantially longer, and not enough that I would consider it an exploit. It is just a play that may be a little bit buggy, but it is a creative, good play nonetheless. Bez doing a great job dancing around the extractor, preventing Squidget from taking him down, and he's in fact going to get out of there. Oh no, there he goes, down to Persian Immortal's rifle, so he almost got out of there. But great to see that early shade play. So the alien team obviously has a shade. Let's go into data core and have a look at what is going on in there. We've got Persian Immortal on the power node there, so he's trying to repair that up. That'll take him for a while without a Mac. We've got a harvester in what's it called? Reactor core. There's my brain ticking over slowly for you. There's that shade. Looks like a fight going on in heliport right now, and a whip. So more standard play. Well, not standard, but definitely a different play to what 156 tried to do in the previous game, where they went double hive drop at the start with no tech. So there's a lot of different paths you can go as aliens at the moment, and marines as well, but definitely the aliens have a lot of strategic variety at their disposal at the moment. And it's great to see that coming out in these organized matches and in pub games that I play in as well. So instead of going the double hive drop, which I would say is a very aggressive strategy, the alien team has gone for a shade drop, which is definitely a creative play, opening up the cloaking possibilities, and also gone for the standard whip, which allows melee one. Melee one, a very dangerous upgrade to get early in the game because it allows you to two-bite marines, as those skulks just did, Vez and me doing a lot of damage there. Me going down, but Vez staying alive and proceeding forwards. It was me that stayed alive and Vez that went down, and he's now going to chew on this extractor. This extractor has already gone down once, so if it goes down again, that'll be a big blow to 156. 156 is being held back in Marine Start at the moment, and look at this, Smaug holding position cloaked, so he's going to be able to cover me back there, and this ridiculous moving you see this Skulk doing is him cloaked and waiting. And go on, bite. There we go, bite. Fantastic ambush by Smaug. He was cloaked, he goes down, but he bought time, crucially, and me wasn't able to take down that extractor, but he was able to do a lot of damage, taking down Persian Immortal, Gunter going down as well. Glassby saying, I wonder why I couldn't move. That is because there was a Skulk sitting there cloaked, preventing him from moving. The extractor goes down. All Marines in ventilation are dead. Keed is, they are really putting the pressure on 156 in this game. This is very, very aggressive aggressive pressure, and it's paying off for them. They're keeping Keed, they're keeping 156 to one base. Keed is denying 156 their extractors. They do have a flight control extractor, although with them all in their base, I wouldn't be surprised to see it go down. It is, in fact, unbuilt on 67%, so it's just begging for some Skulk Jaws to chew it up right there, and it's not giving 156 any resources at the moment. Interesting tidbit about 156, they were formed way back in Alpha Build 156, way back when, for those of you who were around to play those very early Alpha Builds, way back to Build 149, I believe it was. These guys, they've been around for a long time, they're a very experienced clan. Keed is a relatively newer clan, but still quite experienced on the Natural Selection 2 beta scene, and they are known for doing some really creative play. 156, I would usually know them for more strong play, not doing anything particularly crazy, but doing everything they do very, very well, and in a very, very disciplined manner. They're a very disciplined team, and they are in fact entering two teams in the NS2HD NS2 beta tournament. So we will see Team 156, Team 1, and Team 2 going up against everyone. Also, a big thing to note is Unknown Worlds Entertainment are entering a developer team in the tournament. They were the 13th team to jump in, and I don't know if that'll be unlucky for them, but they are going to be in there, and they're going to be playing for the $450 prize, just like everyone else. And so it's great to see them in there. It looks like the alien team has locked down flight control, and the misery is just, it's going on for 156. They've done a great job pushing into data core. If they can hold that and get that extractor, that'll be great for them. This extractor in flight control has gone down. That's bad for them. So on balance, good or bad, I definitely think taking data core is a great plus, because still, no second hive from Keed. They probably have gone for the upgrades. Unlike 156 that went for the double hive earlier on, they've gone for the upgrades. And they've probably got melee 1, maybe even melee 2. They've definitely got camouflage and a shade. So that's probably why. And they've got 2 harvesters apart from their start harvester. So 3 in total. So that's probably why we're not seeing more hives dropped, or at least a second hive dropped. Because I believe by the mid game right now, the alien team should probably be getting out a second hive and going for those fades, those deadly, deadly aliens. 156 doing a great job holding in here. The power is on. The extractor is up. There are no aliens in here. One alien coming in one at a time. It's just not good. Although Smaug, Keed, they are the cloaking clan. They are just crazy cloakers, and almost paying off for them there. They're now copping fire. Can they consolidate? Yes, Wildman taking down McGlaspie and Wildman taking down Persian Immortal. So great cloaking play. Keed, definitely a very experienced shade-using clan. They know all about the shade, and for them, the shade is just a staple of their diet when they're playing on the alien side. Also got some Skulks harassing alien. Marine Start. Bear Glue is cloaked, goes in for the infantry portal there. One of my favorite things to do is chill here as a Skulk, cloaked. Just chill, go up, bite the armory, maybe down 20%, and then hide again. And just keep doing that. And the Marines, if they don't have an observatory, won't be able to find you. And you might even be able to take down the armory, or at least force them back into their base. We've got McGlaspie and Persian Immortal coming through this doorway, probably checking for a hive. You can see McGlaspie checking over there with his rifle for a hive, and not seeing anything. Fighting going on back at Marine Start and at flight control, so I'm not sure what these two Marines are doing. They may have to pull back, but no, they're not. Okay, it looks like we've got one Skulk in Marine Start. One Skulk, two Skulks in Data Core, so it looks like Data Core has been retaken, although these Marines are coming up from behind. McGlaspy and Persian Mortal going from behind. They are going for... whoa, what is going on in here? I must have missed this earlier, but it looks like the Siths have gone down. I think 156 doing a great job just leaving that Harvester to die and instead pushing through to attack Alien Start. So great to see this aggressiveness from 156. This is what wins you games. Their grenades now going off all over Alien Start, explosions everywhere, and Skulks coming in to try and clean it up. They're going to have their work cut out for them. Grenades, McGlaspy sacrificing himself to take down Fish, Scardy Bob taking down Bear Glue, but it wasn't enough. They did go down, and that attack has been stopped. But the Whip, 7%, the Hive, 67%, and Cloaked, and the Harvester, 52%, so an incredibly successful attack from 156. If they were keeping an eye on the damage they had done, that attack was great from the Marine side, but ambushed by a couple of Skulks. Two grenade kills from Squidget, killing Vez and me. If 156 was watching the health tickers on those buildings while they attacked, I think they would do very well to attack again. They will know they've done massive damage to that alien hive. They need to get in there again and capitalize on that damage and not let the alien team simply heal it up with a crag. Although they don't have crags, they will need a gorge to do that because they don't have a second hive, and therefore they are stuck with only shade tech at the moment. It looks like these Marines are chilling, although a cloaked skulk coming in, two cloaked skulks, keyed using those cloaking skills. And I don't think there's anything 156 could have done to combat that. There is no Marine upgrade that can allow individual Marines to spot cloaked aliens yet. We may see it in future. Whoa, what a grenade hit by Gunter on Smorg. There is no ability. There is the observatory, but without maybe two or three observatories, you just don't have the energy to constantly scan areas where Marines may be in danger. Vez just chilling. He doesn't have camouflage evolved, so he's not becoming cloaked. So it looks like this attack has been stopped. I'm going to leave that and check out what is going on in Crevice, because there is a Marine down here. What? Two Marines here. We've got McGlaspy and Persian Mortal again. These two make a deadly team. They often move together. They've often been moving together in this game and doing a lot of damage to the Marine team. Persian Mortal sacrificing himself to kill Vez and me, and I think that is a good option. The scan going down a little bit late. Two scans coming down. So this hive has been completely healed up. The Harvester is being healed up. There are now Hydras here, so I don't think that 156 is going to have the same opportunity to do damage, but they are going to try, and this is great. They are being aggressive, and this is what you've got to do. They've got ventilation and flight control harvesters. Extractors. Alien teams have harvesters, and Marine teams have extractors, and I get that mixed up sometimes. They're in a relatively good position. I mean, much prefer as a Marine to be outside Alien Start than to be in Marine Start facing off against aliens. Interesting that we're seeing no shotguns. So in this whole matchup, 156 and Keed, both very experienced clans, and neither of them really going for fast shotguns, instead going for fast grenades. And that might be indicative of a shift in tactics broadly by Marine teams in Natural Selection 2 Beta at the moment, as teams try to take advantage of the area damage that grenades can do. See those snipes coming from... Sorry, they weren't snipes, they were spikes coming from a Hydra. These Marines just waiting here. They're going to have to watch out for cloaked aliens. They don't have rifle butt. Squidget has rifle butt, and he just got a rifle butt kill. So how's that for timing? The grenades are going down on these Sists and pushing them back slowly. That one on 70%. The alien screaming as it starts to... The hive screaming as it starts to take damage. A big Marine attack going in here. Those two Marines getting a little bit aggressive and going down, but there are still two here. McGlaspy healing up Squidget's armor there. Always good to do that, especially in an attack like this when you need to maintain armor. One Marine going down, one Skulk going down there. And now the Marines are just sitting outside Alien Start. I'd love to see a phase gate and a power pack right now, but I don't know if they have the resources or the tech. Maybe phase gates aren't researched, but that would just be great. But importantly, check out Heliport. There has been a second hive dropped. So if that hive goes up, well, I think 156 is going to be in a lot of trouble because Fades will be on the field. They won't have Phase Tech. You need Phase Tech to fight Fades. You need shotguns, flamethrowers, and Phase Tech. That is a big outlay to fight a specific alien. The best way to fight Fades is to kill the hives that allow them to appear on the field. Heliport is growing. I think if 156 abandoned this attack on Alien Start and shifted over to Heliport, they may have a chance to take it out, but they're not going to get that chance because Bear Glue just cleaned up the whole fight, and that is it for that Marine attack, and a Crossroads drop as well Whoa, Keed is exploiting the resources it has built up, and they are dropping, they've dropped two hives. I would not be surprised to see this hive go down. There's no one really here to protect it. We've got two Gorges on the Keed team, which may be one too many, although it's easy to say that as an armchair commentator who is looking at this with 20/20 vision. It may be too many Gorges, and that hive has gone down, and there is a Marine in Heliport. So this is crucial, gnarly gameplay right now, because it is up to 156 to kill these hives. If these hives go up, even for a second, a Skulk is gonna start evolving, and that will be that for 156's map control. They've demonstrated map control, which is rare for a Marine team to do that. They're demonstrating that skill and maturity and discipline I was talking about earlier to take map control from the alien team. You'd normally expect aliens to have default map control because they are so mobile, and now the grenade's landing on the hive. So Heliport under attack, and it is crucial that 156 take down Keed's growing hive in here. If they do, they can deny the fades, and they can set up for another attack on Alien Start. If they don't, the fades are going to appear, and if the fades appear, then 156 is going to be on the back foot all of a sudden. So really, really crucial that they take this down. The Gorge trying to heal up the hive and attack at the same. It goes down. Fantastic play from 156. That is exactly what they needed to do. And now Keed, well, they're on the back foot again, as they were earlier. They lost a Gorge in that attack, and they have lost two hives now. So that is a huge outlay of team resources that they've just lost. And what Keed, sorry, what 156 needs to do now is pressure. Capitalize on this, capitalize on the fact that the alien team has no team resources left to do anything really. Kill harvesters, kill harvesters, kill harvesters. It is so important. They're often overlooked, but they're utterly crucial. If you kill a harvester, you just do so much damage to an alien team. I'm a bit worried that there's no phase gate. There is a Skulk in Marine Start. I can see one sentry gun in there, but the entire Marine team is attacking at Crevice. Now this is good, they've done enough. Oh, but me is gonna be able to keep this harvester alive. I was about to say, great job ignoring the harvester, not ignoring it, sorry, because that's bad. You should kill them, as I was saying earlier, but killing the Sist, doing enough damage to let the harvester die on its own, and then pushing through. Persian Mortal saying GG, and I think it's those Skulks I was just talking about earlier, because they've killed the infantry portals and are now chewing on the command station. So unless these Marines can kill this base, it is gonna be GG for them. So what an amazing turnaround for Keed. This is the second time in this matchup they've done it. They've killed the infantry portals, and that is what you get when you've got no phase gates and the entire Marine team on the other side of the map. And so that is definitely, there was definitely skill from Keed. There's nothing buggy or exploity about that. That was just, they recognized where the Marine team was, and they pushed in the on the opposite side of the map, which was the Marine base. So well done to both teams. Thank you to both teams for having me and allowing me to cast both game, all three of these games, and cast both teams. And thank you to all my viewers who have watched this. I hope you've enjoyed it. Leave comments to let me know what you liked, what you didn't like, and what you'd like to see in future videos. And that is it for this matchup of three games. And that goes to Keed. So see you all soon, everyone, for more NS2HD videos.